afternoon. As you're seeing from the description on the video, yes, this is a practice session. I'm not planning on doing anything intensive. It's going to just be a short, quick video for the most part. I kind of just wanted to demonstrate a little bit of what a practice session is like. I think that most people are privy to the performing aspect of musicianship, but they don't really see a whole lot of what's behind the scenes. And I am seeing more pianists and other musicians do practice videos like this. And it's something that I've been wanting to do for a long time, just have not gotten around to it. But I thought it'd be nice to do. And for any of my students watching, this will be nice for you too. And I plan on including a few practice tips along the way, just some general things in case there's something that you're working on at home that you're looking to improve and develop a little bit more. So what I'm working on today is Schubert's Impromptu No. 1 from Opus 90. Opus 90 contains 4 impromptus. The third one I have done and will in fact be featuring in an upcoming video. And what I'm working on for today, like I said, is No. 1. And it's a lengthy piece. Mostly what I'm focusing on right now are just the first few pages. And so I will show you some of that and see what you think of it. And I'll kind of mention a few things along the way that might be good for you to hear. Like I said, especially if you are practicing something at home. So what I like about this piece is that there is a lot of contrast. There are a lot of very strong sort of, marching, almost sort of militant parts. And then you have these other, more delicate flowing sorts of parts to it that require a whole different technique. And so that's kind of why I wanted to do this for the practice session video, so that I could kind of talk about, a little bit of all these different things to it. So anyway, this is how it begins. Very strong, powerful. Kind of supposed to grab your attention right away. Then it moves to this. Developed in the next part.
Thank you.
have a smooth sound to it. It's supposed to have more of a connected sound. But the reason I'm adding the pedal in is kind of for the resonance more than anything. So that's something that I'm going to have to work out a bit, because we want it to sound nice and full and thunderous, but you don't want heavy pedal sounds in an area that isn't really indicated that way. So maybe more. Nature of what you're working on. So, do you hear that? And the first time around, I missed those. But now I didn't. Okay, so I want to make sure I bring out everything. I don't want to miss any details. Presented in a different way. The technique is totally different compared to what I worked on earlier, as you can hear. So what we have is, for the lack of a better term, a simple melody, which is this. It's very sweet, very flowing. So in this section, the left hand is really doing most of the work, as you might have heard. So that's the part that requires the most practice to make sure everything is connected. So you just kind of have this perpetual motion of eighth note triplets, basically, is what they are right here. So I'm going to try it one more time time for right now. A little slower, because I think that that's what I would need to do to really make sure that everything is connected, stays connected. I was going to mention something about bringing out melody. That is probably one of the best general tips that I can give to anybody, and it's something that I say to my students all the time. When you're dealing with, you know, something melodious like this, something that has like a singing quality is basically what we're talking about. You really want that to ring out over everything else. And so the left hand here is the accompaniment, which we don't want to drown out the right hand with, which is where our, you know, our melody is here. We want that to stay nice and strong, okay, above the accompaniment patterns. And here later, we get to into some octaves here. The best thing to do, what we say, is to ping the top notes. To ping the top notes. So that means that those notes should ring out above the lower note of the octave. So for instance, and hopefully this comes through on the video, but when I play this octave with an equal weight with my thumb and my pinky, it's not a bad sound, but as my teacher would call it, it sounds a little pedestrian. So, doesn't sound like anything special. Okay, now what I'm going to do is shift weight to the upper note so that I can help that ring out a little bit more. For is to ping those upper notes. So I'm going to try it one more time, like I said, and let's see if it's I can smooth it out a little bit by slowing my tempo. But hopefully this helped you a little bit if you're working on something at home. Just remember the basic general tips I went over today was first bringing out the melody notes. When you're playing in octaves, make sure to ping the upper note. Not ridiculously heavy or anything, just enough to ring out, okay, above your accompaniment. Because that lower note of the octave kind of serves as more of part of the accompaniment, okay? Your real melody's got to be the upper note. So that was another thing. And just watch your tempo. You know, that's something that I say to my students. It's something that I work on myself. Slowing down a little bit makes a huge difference in terms of your overall progression in the piece. Sometimes we get a little impatient with ourselves. We start rushing through things, you know, wanting to hurry up and get it. That will only end up, this is laptop, my cat. That will only end up, you know, taking longer. It'll take you a lot longer to accomplish what you want when, you you know, you're rushing through it, even though there's sometimes a tendency to do that. So yeah, definitely slow your tempo, and watch how, you know, fast you progress. And I would definitely say practice with a metronome. And my students know that word very well. I practice with a metronome myself. You can use one that is mechanical, such as this. I have this one. I also have a metronome app, and a lot of my students have metronome apps, so that's definitely something that's available to you for free, you know, with whatever phone or tablet or whatever you have device. So anyway, hopefully this was helpful to you, and I hope to do some more videos like this and see if they're helpful for you. And it was fun for me, for sure, to be able to kind of show you my practicing process a little bit. So have yourselves a great day, and thank you for watching. Subscribe for more videos. Thank you. Bye.